night. Hi guys, I'm not going to whisper today because my daughter's not sleeping in the same room. I am going to use that NYX palette again, and this time I'm using the blues. I'm trying to make it daytime wearable again so that I can go to work without feeling horribly garish or hookerish. So let's go ahead and get started so I can get out the door because this eye took way too long. I'm going to start first with the Shiseido Aqua Shimmer, and I think that's what it's called, Aqua Shimmer. I'll put it in the link, and just, oh, that's too much, the tiniest bit of it. Make sure you use some sort of primer. This is a cream eyeshadow. It can easily crease. Too Faced Shadow Insurance, L'Oreal Decrease, Urban Decay Primer Potion, whatever you prefer. Okay, so you see how bright that color was, but I did use just a really thin layer. Just put a little bit more just to make sure they match. My eyes are gonna match. Okay, next thing I'm gonna do is I'll use three brushes today. The Ulta Crease Brush, Pointed Crease Brush, just like a big brother to the MAC 219. Going into that white shade first, load up the tip. And we're just doing the inner tear duct area because this white is sheer. So to put it on top of that blue base, it still is going to give off a blue tint. But I'm just trying to open up the eye area. Now, with this one, I did apply powder. You'll see some of it on my nose, so I do have a little bit of a skunk going on, or a raccoon eyes going on. Next, I'm going to go into this medium blue shade. This one's really soft, so be really careful because I've already put in a considerable little dent for no reason. So we're going to go over the middle of the eye, the middle third, overlapping where we put in that white that looks a bluish silver color because of the base. Next, we're going to go into this last color here on the top row that is a gray blue. And it does blend into this other color really well. It's very subtle, and you guys know me, I'm not terribly into subtle. So again, I'm going to bring the crease color just over to the eyeball, the outer two-thirds. Then I'm going to take the 217, I'm going to tap it once, twice, into that same blue color, and then I'm going to blend this out. I went too far on the inner crease earlier today, so on the other eye, so it's part of what took me so long. So I'm not going to do it again. So now I'm cleaning off the brush a little bit, trying to keep that crease color, stopping it there. I don't want to travel all the way across my crease with that color. Now I'm looking to see if I can get them to match. Build up my brow and the crease right here a little bit. Again, because I have hooded eyes. You guys know you can't see the color unless I build it up a little bit. Okay, so here's the little added kicker. Here is the L'Oreal Hip Duo, Metallic Shadow Duo, and Magnetic. Okay, it's right there. And that dark blue is darker than the blue in the NYX palette. And a bit more blue. So I'm going to load that up just the very tip on my Ulta Pointed Crease Brush, and I'm going to do the outer V. See it there? So here to here. Just a teeny bit more for the top part of the crease. Okay, and then I can blend inward a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to go in with the 217. I didn't clean it off or anything. It's still dirty from that dark blue from the NYX palette. And I'm just going to blend in really, really dark blue. So just creating an illusion of some depth. If you want to, you can keep doing it until you get your desired effect. It's all trial and error, just adding a little bit at a time. You don't want to go overboard. Alright, so I noticed though, this time and last time from the blending, I lose that darker blue color a little bit from the NYX palette, so I have to go back in and put it in there. Just from the blending, because I don't want to blend that color too far, so it starts to rub the other color off. Alright, so for the lashes, clean off my crease brush. I go into the medium blue, the color on the bottom of the NYX palette. Apply it to my lower lash line without getting it in my eyeball. And then I'm going to use the L'Oreal Hip Blue out here. A darker side and that Magnetic Duo. It's more blue than the NYX one. The NYX is more gray. Alrighty. So the next thing I did is I used a really small art brush. I don't normally show you guys my eyeliner, but I wanted to just show you today that I did only do the outer third of my lashes. So you want to make sure it's not dry. You want to have it soft, so it's a little pliable. I'm using my Wet n Wild gel eyeliner. They're really cheap, you know, so I shouldn't get BOGO. Alright, so I loaded that up. And I'm going to start from the outside in. And normally that's what I do. I start outside in, inside out, inside in. So I kind of meet them in the middle. But today, so I can follow kind of the darkness of my crease color. And I just taper it. So as I reach the outside, make it just a little bit thicker. And then just the smallest flick. So see, it's just tapered. And it might be a bit more obvious now, but after the mascara is on, you won't notice that I have eyeliner only on the outer part of my eye. So let me go and put on my mascara. Take off the powder under my eye, put on some blush, and I'll be right back. Forgot to tell you, I did use highlight again from this trio and the half inch Lil Cornell Maxi Mops brush and hit the brow and helped smoke out and take out any harsh lines in the crease. Forgot to tell you. All right, be right back. All right, guys, so there is the finished look. I put on my mascara and I put on some blush. Today I'm using a Jane Blush and Blossom. And on top of that, just on the tops of the cheekbones, I used this Meteorites in Pink Fresh. I used just a little skunk brush. I dip it down in there and then apply it just like so. On my lips today, I'm using a Bare Essentials Buxom Lip Gloss in Trixie, and that's it. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye for now. One more time.